The Bible expects followers of Christ to yearn for and yield to local church accountability. And just so you know, now the Bible is taking things way over the top. Listen to Matthew chapter 18, verse 15 through 17. Jesus says, "If your brother sins against you, go and tell him his fault between you and him alone. If he listens to you, you have gained your brother. But if he does not listen, take one or two others along with you, that every charge may be established by the evidence of two or three witnesses. And if he refuses to listen even to them, follow this, tell it to the church. And if he refuses to listen even to the church, let him be to you as a Gentile and a tax collector." In other words, if a brother is unrepentant in sin and they won't turn after private correction with one or two or three people, Jesus says, tell it to the church. So what does that mean? Does that mean tell it to the entire global body of Christ? No, that means tell it to the members, the other parts of that man's local church. And then if he refuses to listen even to the church as a whole, then you remove him from the church as a whole. I think about my life. If I am wandering off into unrepentant sin in a way that will destroy my life or my marriage or my family or the reputation of Christ, then I want brothers and sisters in Christ in my life who will love me enough to warn me not to go that way. I yearn for a church that will love me enough to call me back if I wander from Christ, which I am prone to do in my sinfulness. This is part of how the Bible defines being a member of a church. Membership means saying, I yearn for this and yield to this from others, and I will carry this out with others. I will pursue others in love, because this is one of the most clear ways that we care for one another in the body of Christ. So we'll talk about this more a few weeks from now. And this accountability is not just between one another. There's other places in the Bible where we see members of the church are accountable before God. According to Scripture, church members are accountable for choosing and appointing leaders who honor God and are good for the church. Acts 6:2-6. Church members are accountable for making sure the gospel is being preached in the church. Galatians 1:6-9 and 2 Timothy 4. So if the gospel is not being preached in the church, then church members are accountable for making sure it's being preached. Church members are accountable for commissioning missionaries from the church. Acts 13:1-3. So you put all this together, you realize, oh, the Bible is flying straight in the face of American individualism, all of our skepticism, and to be honest, straight in the face of much of our contemporary church culture, and is begging every follower of Christ to ask the question, where are you committed as a member, a part of a local church? Not even just where's your name on a church roll somewhere, or where do you attend worship to listen to a sermon, but where are you committed to gathering together every week you can with a group of believers where you're mutually submitting to the Word of God and to one another, where you're giving to one another, where you're caring for one another, where you're taking responsibility for helping other members of that body grow in faith, basically carrying out the functions of a church together. That is what church membership is.